And joining us tonight, Assembly Speaker Fabian Nunez and Senate Republican Roy Ashburn from Bakersfield. Good to have you with us this evening.
Thank you for having me.
Speaker Nunez, let's begin with you tonight. If you do not get some sort of cooperation, I take it, from Republicans and the gains they have made, are you talking about starting over here?
There's no question we're going to start over. I think the hyper-partisanship on the part of some of my good friends in the Senate Republican caucus, I think, is really a political stunt to demonstrate to the people of California clearly that the Republicans in the Senate are totally and completely out of touch with the values and with the voters of the state of California. To hold the budget hostage, as they have been doing, it proves absolutely no point. Essentially, what this is going to be government shutdown and government meltdown. We're headed down that direction. I think the Republicans in the Senate need to come to terms with reality and pass that budget. They need one Republican vote. Maybe Mr. Ashburn can vote for it.
Mr. Ashburn, you ready to vote for it, or are you going to hold firm?
I'm ready to vote for a balanced budget. The simple question that Speaker Nunez needs to answer is this budget balanced? And the answer is no. It's about $700 million out of balance. Every Californian understands in their home budget, they must balance their budget. Same with government. I don't want to return to the bad old days of the budget crises under Gray Davis. And that's where we're headed if we pass an irresponsible budget.
Well, we're talking about a $700 million deficit, but is that the real issue here, or is it the environmental issue? You want to prevent cities, counties, and developers from being sued if they don't meet certain climate change demands that have been described as, you know, being necessary to keep California in step with the rest of the world.
Well, part of the budget is keeping faith with the people of California, who just passed $40 billion in bonds to build our roads, to fix our bridges, to repair the water system in California, to build the schools. Those facilities will not be constructed if Jerry Brown, the Attorney General, is filing lawsuits against other government agencies to implement and enforce regulations that are not in place.
Yeah, but,
so
but
if we're going to deliver what we promised to the people in passing those construction bonds, then we need to put an end to the lawsuits that accomplish nothing. That's part of the budget.
That is absolutely, it has nothing to do with the budget. If we talk about, you know, I know Senator Ashburn said he would vote for a balanced budget. Interestingly enough, the budget that the Assembly approved over 2.5 weeks ago, not only is it a balanced budget, it has the highest reserve ever of any budget in the history of California, $3.7 billion of a reserve, and there is an operating deficit of $700 million. But guess what? The operating deficit doesn't impact this year's budget. Might impact next year's budget, the year after that. That's the structural budget gap. The Constitution does not require us to fix the structural budget gap the same year you're required to balance the budget for that year. The issue of CEQA and the implementation of our effort to combat greenhouse gas emissions with AB 32 has nothing to do with the budget whatsoever. And so to hold the budget hostage, to try and help the friends of my friends on the Republican side of the aisle that are developers, much of these folks are my friends as well, but they have no reason to be holding up the budget of California, to tell blind people in the state, to tell senior citizens in the state, to tell people that depend upon the important services of the state that they will no longer get the services that they need because Mr. Ashburn and members of his caucus have decided to draw the line in the sand and essentially stand against something that has nothing to do with the budget. It's irresponsible, in my view.
How much of an issue is it that those holding out here are worried about even more conservative challengers in their districts?
That's not an issue at all. What we're trying to achieve is a balanced budget for the people of California, a fiscally responsible budget. It takes $700 million. The Speaker just acknowledged that.
Is there a point
to bring this budget into balance?
But there is.
We have presented over $1 billion of suggestions that don't affect health care, that don't affect education, that don't affect public safety.
How is it possible that you're going to be able to negotiate any other issues when this bickering continues? The voters are fed up with all of you, frankly.
And I don't blame the voters to be fed up. I think the real problem is not Senator Ashburn, myself, or even for that matter, the Republican caucus. It's the the requirement that we have in the California Constitution that requires two-thirds of the legislature to approve a budget. You know, California is only one of three states in the entire country that has a two-thirds voter threshold. What happens under this circumstance is that this concept of majority rule in government doesn't apply anymore. It's a minority within the minority party that gets to dictate the terms of the budget, and that's what's happening right now.
All right, Mr. Nunez is going to give Mr. Ashburn, Senator Ashburn, the last comment here. I want to ask you, Senator, Governor Schwarzenegger, a Republican, has said that he will redline the budget, that he'll cut down that $700 million deficit. Is it you don't trust the governor?
Well, each of the parts of our government need to do their job. It's the job of the legislature to pass a balanced budget, and then it goes to the governor, and he has veto authority before he gives his final signature. It's our job to make sure this budget is balanced, and that's what this is about, keeping faith with the people of California that those $40 billion in bonds are implemented in as timely a manner as possible, and to make sure that we balance the state budget. It's good that Speaker Nunez is back from his European vacation. Maybe now we can get busy on the budget.
Well, Senator Ashburn, I wish you could go on vacation. We need to improve the budget, but make no mistake about it.
Hey, you guys cannot have to take it outside.
No, but make no mistake about it. You will not approve a budget if you want to make
Senator
deeper
Ashburn,
cuts.
Speaker Nunez, thanks so much for
thank you very
right.
much.
Thank you very much.
The inability of lawmakers to pass a budget is the focus of tonight's KCRA.com survey. Excuse me. We want to know who you blame for the budget standoff.
Who do you want to go on vacation? All right.
Democrats, Republicans, or both. Log on to KCRA.com and give us your opinion. You'll find the survey under the Daily Extras section on the homepage.